Hi guys, I'm Nick from KLINGSPOR Abrasives.
And I'm Mike Zee with KLINGSPOR's Woodworking Shop.
We would like to talk to you today about a sanding technology that's been around for a lot of years, but at the same time is still widely in use throughout many of our woodworking industries today. That is the pump sleeve. What is a pump sleeve, you may ask? If you're not familiar with these, they are simply a flexible abrasive that is made into a belt or a sleeve that will go on to a pump drum. The pump drum is then inflated with air and puts pressure on the sleeve to hold it in place. But these are great for sanding contours, chair legs, all different kinds of pieces. And so we've put together a 5-part video series that will help you to understand not only about the pump sleeves, the pump drums, but also what can possibly go wrong. What kind of things can you face if you have one of these? And also we're gonna talk to you about a repair kit that we have on hand too. So if you're wondering what in the world is a pump sleeve, what's a pump drum, stay tuned.
So what is a pump sleeve and a pump drum? Well, a pump sleeve is simply a flexible belt. That's how we consider it. And the pump drum is a pneumatic drum that's air inflated. Normally, depending on the workpiece, the contours that you have, what you want to make sure is that you don't overinflate the drum. You keep it around 20 to 15 PSI, but it all depends on what your workpiece is. But you definitely have to deflate your drum in order to get the pump sleeve off. But the pump sleeve, what makes it nice is that it's flexible. The joint that's on it, though, is a very special joint called a number one joint. It has no tape. And what that means that you'll have a perfectly consistent surface area when you're sanding, but also means you need to make sure you follow the arrows. The arrows are very important that you're working with the workpiece as it's coming around. You will find that your pump drum should always have some sort of canvas sock, and sometimes you'll find sweater or sock material on top of that. That's not uncommon. But you simply just slide it on, make sure you have the arrows going with the direction that you want to have it on. And when you inflate with air, it will hold it in place. It won't come off. So definitely don't need any kind of adhesives or tapes around the outside edge. If you find yourself needing that, your sleeve might actually not be the right size.
Now that Mike has made you aware of how a pump sleeve works in conjunction with a pump drum, I want you to understand that not all sleeves are created equal. The reason I say that is we see a lot of confusion out there in the market between different kinds of sleeves. The one I'm referring to here, we refer to as a no-lap band. We call it a spiral band, but it's also called a sanding sleeve. So you can see where the confusion can come into play between the sanding sleeve and the pump sleeve. The difference is the fact that this is abrasive, affixed onto a hard cardboard tube. Where this is used is in this machine right here, an oscillating spindle sander. This hard cardboard tube with the abrasive on it is pushed down over this hard rubber drum. Now this drum does not require any air. All you do to expand this drum is tighten down on the top nut, the rubber on the drum expands, and holds the sleeve into place. So the way to tell the difference between this type of sleeve and the pump sleeve is looking at the drum. If you see a drum with a nut on the end that expands when you turn the nut, that is for the no-lap bands or the spiral bands. If you see an air inlet valve on the end of the drum, then you know it's for a pump sleeve. Thank you for watching our introductory video to pump sleeves. What can we look forward to next, Mike?
Next, we're going to find out how you can measure your pump drum or pump sleeve to find out what one's going to fit best for you. So stay tuned.